Hi, this is Kevin from schutzhundkevin.com, and today we'll be tackling how to teach the send out. Ba-da-boom. So to teach the send out, first thing is we want to have the dog with developed prey drive. Typically around 10, 12 months, your dog has enough ball drive to be able to send them to a dead ball sitting there that they're going to go bite it and be rewarded by it. So when I first teach this, I like the send out pole with the hanger so the dogs can run through and bite the ball. I find this helps create speed and commitment all the way through the send out instead of starting with the tug on the ground and then just biting it off the ground. I believe the run through helps with my dog's speed. So when we first teach this, we start close and we work our way back. Important rule for this is the ball is always at the end of the field. We don't start at this basic position at the start of the field and gradually move the ball away from you. The send out pole is at the end of the field. So when we're first teaching this, we'll start close, tease your dog with a toy, have them settle or down, show them the toy, go hang it up, come back to them. And this is where I start my ritual of where's your toy? Then I'll grab their collar, get them in drive and point to it. As soon as they look at that toy on hanging, I'll say vraus, and then they can go get the toy. First thing is to teach the drive to go. So I'm not worried about foosing in basic position. I have my dog in the down, tease them with the ball, go hang it, come back to the dog, tell them where's their toy, grab their collar, and I'll get barking and pulling, and then release them when they're barking and pulling to create that drive for the send out. Sit. Where's your toy? Vraus. Yes, good boy, come. And as we progress, they get the ball, have them come back, play with them, go farther down the field another 5-10 steps, plot them, out them, show them the ball, come hang it again, come back to the dog, where's your toy, grab the collar, load them, and then send them. And we do this until we can do a full field send out, meaning I come onto the field, I'll down my dog, show him the toy, walk all the way down the field, show them the toy from a distance, hang it up, come back to the dog, do the where's your toy, grab their collar, get them in drive, and send them. We want full commitment and speed all the way for the full length of the Schutzhund field. Once I have that, then I can go back and introduce control. So to condition the dog to the mark, we'll say where's your toy and point, and then as they're looking, then I'll send them with that vraus command. So this is good on practice day when you halt, you can say where's your toy and point. Trial day, you can't do this much help. That's why I would condition it to the voice command. But when they're sitting, we tell them, where's your toy point? Make sure until you see them look at that pole, vraus. If they're looking off to the side, come. We don't want to send them. We want to send them when they're actually looking down at the pole. Settle. Good. Whoos. So I maintain my foos position. Where's your toy point? Good. Then foos, where's your toy? I know my dog knows right where it is. Foos, and I can send him from healing. Vraus. Yes, good boy, come. So I'll go about half field, hang the toy, still show him the ball, hang it, come back to them, have them sit, ask for foos, foos a couple steps, halt, then we can tell them where's your toy again, have them bark and pull and send, and then eventually I'll send them from that foosing before I do a hidden send out. So we'll show them the toy, set it up, come back down. Where's your toy? Foos! Foos! Sit. Where's your toy? Foos! Foos! As they're foosing, halt, foos, foos, halt, and then as you're foosing, vraus, and then send them from maintaining that eye contact. It's important when we're starting this is we don't pay them for half eye contact. We want to have full commitment with that eye contact. And it's important that we maintain with that anticipation as we foos, halt, foos, halt, foos, and then send them so they don't know it's at 10 paces we always send them, and then they'll start anticipating that. So the next part for this is introducing the blind send out, and this is when the dog doesn't see you load the send out pole. So the way I go about this is I'll take a step back and I'll do a multiple ball send out. I find this helps the dogs to learn to commit to the end of the field whether they see me put it there or not. So I'll actually put 6 balls by that send out pole, and this part is where I'll switch to it on the ground because I can't hang 6 of them. But we'll just put 4 or 6 balls on the ground right by that pole. Send the dog, they'll go and mark with that yes, they'll get the ball. And some dogs will be like, oh my gosh, there's 6 balls here, I gotta get all. As soon as they grab one, call them back with your recall command, make them come back. And then when we start this, I'll start back at like a quarter field instead of the full send outs. And then they come back, you've played with the ball, you'll take the ball from them. Same, where's your toy and cue them. And they might think you have the toy and there's no point to run away. So this is where I'm close again, tell them Varaus. They go 2 feet and look back at you, tell them, no, Varaus, keep walking down the field and pointing.
Yes, boy,
and then when they commit and go find the ball, call them back and do it again. It goes pretty quick to where if you're close enough and you say Varaus, they're going to go find the ball very quickly and come back out the ball, and they know there's more balls down there to send them again to it. So once I can do the multiple ball send at a full field with some foosing, then I'll introduce a blind send out, meaning, you know, we've done send outs 3 days in a row, and then on the 4th day, I'll preload the send out pole with the toy. I'll do some obedience, cue them, where's your toy, and then send them. When I first do the blind send out, again, I'm going to be about quarter field, just far enough they can't see the ball hanging, and they'll run 10, 15 feet and then be able to see the send out pole and commit to it. So the reason I use the send out pole is to teach the dogs, when I say Varaus, if you run straight long enough, you're going to see that send out pole and be able to go find your reward. Also with the send out pole, the majority of Schutzhund fields have a goal post or a football field goal post at the end of the field. So it makes a really easy marker for the dogs. We go to the send out pole at the end of the Schutzhund field. So the next point is after we teach that mark with the hand is to pattern it into the routine. So when I'm getting ready for a trial, I'll only do the send outs after the retrieves or after a dumbbell stand. So to teach this, I'll move my dumbbell stand a little bit closer downfield, put my dumbbell back, ask my dog, where's your toy? Pat his chest, foos straight to the middle, not all the way at the end of the field. Tell them, where's your toy again? Have him mark and then send him. So after a few reps of this, we're gonna condition dumbbell away, where's your toy, and pat the chest. Foos out to the middle and send the dog. So to introduce the down to the send out, I'll go back close to the send out pole, less than a quarter of the field. We'll load it a couple times, send them through, send them through, send them through. And then I'll pretend I load the send out pole. I won't put the ball there, I'll come back to the dog. Same ritual, where's your toy? Grab their collar, get them in drive. Varaus, and then about 6 feet out from the send out pole, I'll tell them plots. I'm not gonna yell it at them. Just tell them plots, they're gonna ignore the command and go check out that pole. This is what I want the dog to do, is to learn that when I say plots, feel free to break, there's nothing there. I'll repeat the plots command again, and as soon as they lay down, I'll say yes, and then have them come back and get the ball for me. So, and then after I've done one down, the next send out, it's gonna be loaded. So you gotta balance the dog of going, committing that the ball's there. If you do 4 downs in a row with no toy, they're gonna not wanna go to the end of the field. So we wanna teach the dogs that if we say Varaus, and we don't say plots, there is a toy, but we condition the dogs that if I say plots, you need to lay down quickly and then the ball is back at the handler. It's not at the end of the field. This is really good for trial day, that having the dogs learn when they hear the handler say plots, there's no point to keep checking the end of the field. The quicker you lay down, the quicker you get paid from the handler. So common problems for the send out are the dog's not committed, or typically it's the dog doesn't know where to go. It's not the dog being disobedient about not wanting to run down the field to find their toy. It's the handlers typically have gone too far with the dog and the dog doesn't know where to go. This typically happens when you're transitioning to other fields. So the first time I'm on a new field, I make sure I send the dog close enough they can be successful. Even when I'm prepping at nationals, when I first send my dog, I'm sending them about half field instead of a full length from the beginning, just to show them the end of the field and where that reward's gonna be at. Another problem for the send out is the dog's veering off and not going to the end of the field. So we wanna set up proofing for this. Definitely move the dumbbell stand out onto the field. You wanna make sure you do your send outs past the hurdle, past the A-frame, past the dumbbell stand. In the proofing phases, once I'm doing the multiple ball sends, I'll actually toss balls on the ground. And if I say Varaus, they have to ignore the balls they can see right on the ground, and they're only allowed to get the ball at the end of the field with that Varaus command. So we want to set that up. You can have other distractions on the field. Another really big one is making sure you have the long down flags Because a lot of dogs will run out and go to the long down flag because they think that's the send out spot or where your toy is. We want to make sure, I'll put out a bunch of dummy flags all over the field and teach them to browse as you run past all the distractions, and the reward's always at the end of the field. Hey guys, thanks for watching. Hope this will help you with your send outs. Don't forget to like, comment, and share below.